When will it all go back to normal? When are we finally going to be on the other side? These questions had to be on the disciples' minds, on Peter, James, and John, and on all the Marys and all of their friends. As those women went to the tomb where their Lord and their teacher and friend lay dead in the grave, they had to be thinking, when? When is it going to go back to normal? When will we be on the other side? Little did they know that with Jesus, you don't go back to normal. The other side, well, after Jesus, the other side looks pretty different too. For all our history, ever since creation, we've been fighting and struggling through all that comes our way, always wondering, when will it go back to normal? What will it be like on the other side? But you know, it's not given to human beings to see the future. As the Apostle Paul once put it, for now we see through a glass darkly, and we know only in part. And so, we walk by faith and not by sight. But we are not alone. On that dark, foreboding night, as Abram lay in the grass and a smoky torch and firepot passed between those animals, Abram could not see the future. Abram could not see the other side, but God could, and God did. And God reckoned it to Abram as righteousness. As the Israelites came to the edge of the Red Sea and the Egyptian army pressed up behind them, they could not see a way forward. They could not see the other side, but God could, and God did, and God brought them through the Red Sea without a drop of water on them. As Jonah sat in the belly of the whale, contemplating all his past unfaithfulness, Jonah could not see a way out. Jonah could not see the other side, but God could, and God did. God landed Jonah safe on Nineveh's shores and used his reluctant voice to change the hearts of all the people. Maybe most importantly, as those women went to the tomb, they could not see anything but sadness, sorrow, and death. They could not see the other side, but God could, and God did. And once and for all, God did away with normal and changed the other side for the rest of kingdom come. It is not given to us human beings to see the future, but we do know our past, and we know it well. No matter the circumstances, no matter the hardships still to come, there is one thing, and one thing only, always on the other side, and that is the Lord your God. God was waiting on the other side of the covenant with Abram. God was waiting on the other side of the Red Sea for the Israelites. God was waiting on the other side of the belly of the whale for wayward old Jonah. And it was God who was waiting on the other side of the crucifixion and the grave of our Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever we go through, whether it be the cross or coronavirus or even death itself, God is the one who is waiting on the other side. On this particular Easter, I know we all long to get back to normal. But you know what? After the resurrection, if all you crave is normal, then you've really missed the point. Brothers and sisters, it's true. We walk by faith and not by sight. But take heart. The God of our past is the God of our future. Alleluia, Christ is risen. And in the name of God, he'll see us through to the other side. Amen.